Hello. We're going to be doing a science experiment today looking at the water cycle. And we're going to be thinking about how water warms up, evaporates into the sky, it cools as it gets higher, and then when it cools, it turns into clouds and then can rain back down as precipitation. So these are the things you're going to need for this experiment. Hot water. Please have your parents help you with this because this water is really hot because we want it to evaporate quickly. Ice, salt, two bowls. Doesn't have to be like this. It could be ceramic, like a breakfast bowl, and then plastic saran wrap. So what we're gonna do is we're going to pour some of this warm water into the big bowl. I'm gonna add some salt in it. What we're trying to do is we're trying to think about the ocean water and think about how much of the Earth's rain is actually from the ocean. It's ocean water that's evaporating. And what happens is the warm water, and it's not going to be this warm, it's going to be warm enough to evaporate still. This is going to evaporate much faster, but it's still warm enough to evaporate. So it evaporates into the sky as vapor, and as it goes up, it cools off. Kind of like how when you look at mountains, even in the summertime, there's still snow at the peaks. That's because the higher you go, the cooler it gets. So if you were to go on a hike and go up the really high mountain, eventually, even if it's a hot day, you'd be kind of cold, you want to put a jacket on. And the same thing happens to the water, and it cools off. And that's when it goes back from vapor back into its water state. And then it collects those clouds, and the wind can blow it far from the ocean. It can blow way from the ocean to Portland or even further. A lot of it ends up blowing all the way to the mountains, like Mount Hood, and then it kind of bumps into it, and then by then it's really cold and it snows. So let's start with our warm water. This water is almost boiling. So I'm gonna pour it into the bowl. I wanna get a little closer video person. So I'm gonna pour some of that into here. And because we're talking about salt water, I'm gonna add some salt because the ocean has a lot of salt. I'm gonna just throw in some salt here. Sometimes you gotta get your finger in there, which is not good table manners. And now there's a lot of salt in there. So that water's gonna taste really salty. I'm gonna put another bowl inside after maybe I stir it with a spoon. Got a little broken spoon here. And stir that up so it should be really nice and salty in there. I'm gonna put this smaller bowl inside it, and we're going to see if we can't get some evaporation to condense up top. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the saran wrap, cover it up. It's probably gonna take two pieces of saran wrap. So that's one. And here comes the second one. And once we have that covered, now what we're gonna do, because we want this experiment to go kind of quickly, we don't wanna have to wait a day to see if we can get some rain happening in our little science experiment here. I'm gonna put some ice on top of the plastic, and that's gonna be kind of like as the vapor goes up into the air, it cools off in that cold air that's up top. But because this isn't really going up all that high, I'm gonna just put some ice up here to really make it cold up top. And we're gonna see if once it gets cold, the vapor isn't gonna turn back into water and then rain back down. And then our hope is that the water that rains back down into that smaller bowl will be fresh water. And the science behind that is the salt molecules are too heavy to just go up in the air like the water. So the salt's gonna stay down in the ocean. So that's why if you're by the beach on a rainy day, it doesn't rain salt on you. If you taste the rain, it just tastes like normal rain. The salt stays in the ocean because it's too heavy to leave. but that doesn't mean the water isn't still leaving the ocean all of the time as evaporation, because it is. So, we've got our warm salt water in there. We've got the smaller bowl. We've got the plastic. We've got the ice. And now we're just gonna wait probably about 10 minutes and we're gonna see what happens.